Hello and welcome to another Angular tutorial. In this video, I'm going to cover something that I need often, a toggle button concept. This type of button will control the visibility of some sort of associated content. We'll look at two main approaches, one where we use a class and some CSS to control the visibility, and another where we use conditional logic to insert content into or remove it from the DOM. We'll also look at a couple of bonus variations with the class-based CSS approach too. Okay, to start off, here's the basic demo application that we're starting from. We have an example component that contains the content that we're seeing here. If we look at the component, we can see that there's nothing here yet, just the basic code needed for an Angular component. If we switch to the template, we can see a little more. Here's the button that we're seeing. The plan is to use this button to toggle the display of the content we see in the purple box. Here's the markup for this box. We'll set this box up to start out hidden. Then when we click the button, a class will be toggled and that class will display the button. Okay, the first thing we need to do is switch back to the code for this component. Here, let's create a protected field called visible. This will be a Boolean property and we'll set its initial value to false. Okay, that's all we need to add here. Now let's switch to the template. The first thing we need to do here is set it up to toggle the visible property value when the button is clicked. We can use simple event binding on the button to bind to the click event. When this event fires, we'll set the visible property equal to the opposite of its current value. Okay, now we can use class binding to bind a class on our box when this property is true. We'll add some CSS for these visible and hidden states in a minute, but first we can swap out the label for this button with a simple ternary operator too. So when visible is true, we'll make the label display the word hide. Then when it's false, the button will display show. Okay, that's all the changes we'll need to make in the template. Now let's switch to the CSS. So we want our box to be hidden by default. Now there's lots of ways to do this, but we'll simply set its opacity to 0 for this example. Then when it has the visible class, we'll set the opacity to 1 so that it shows. Okay, that should do it. Now let's save and see how it works. Okay, so now the box is not showing by default. Now when we click the button, the content shows. Then when we click it again, it hides. So now you know how to hide and show content by conditionally binding a class and adding some basic CSS. And there are definitely many variations to this concept too. For example, if you had a concept like a paragraph of text like this, you can pretty easily change the CSS around a little to truncate the first line of text, hiding the rest, and then when the button is clicked, display the full text. To do this, let's remove the CSS we added from the previous example. Now, when the box does not have the visible class, let's add some new styles. For this example, we needed to add an inner div specifically for these styles to be applied correctly. So we'll need to be sure to include it as part of our selector. Now let's add overflow hidden to hide the content we don't want to see. Then let's add the text overflow property. We'll set it to ellipsis. Next, let's add the white space property. Let's give it a value of no wrap. And then we just need to set the width to 100% to keep the content from overflowing horizontally. That's it. Everything else remains the same. Let's save and try this out. There, now the text starts out truncated to a single line. Then when we click the button, the full message is displayed. Pretty cool, right? And we can even change this to instead show the first two lines with content fading out at the bottom before toggling to show the full paragraph. To do this, we can first remove everything except overflow hidden. Then we can add a height to constrain our content. Let's go with 2 em. Now let's fade the content out at the bottom. We'll use the mask image property for this, along with a linear gradient. Okay, that's everything we need for this example. Let's save and check it out now. There, now the content shows almost two lines and then fades out at the bottom. Then when we click the button, we see all of the content. And then when we click it again, it goes back down to two lines. So those are just some common scenarios that I've encountered, and I'm sure there are many others out there. Now, rather than using a conditional class, you may want to instead add or remove some content when the button is clicked. Well, this is pretty easy to do as well. Let's take our first example again. Let's simply wrap the box in a condition based on whether the visible property is true or not. So now it will be inserted into the DOM when true and be removed when false. Now we can remove the class binding. Also, we can remove the CSS used to control visibility. Okay, that's it. Let's save and see how it looks. Okay, so now it's not there to start. Now when we click the button, it shows. And then when we click it again, it's removed. So this works exactly the same as the first example. It's just conditionally adding and removing the content instead of using a class and CSS to show and hide it. Okay, so now you should have some handy concepts for creating buttons that can be used to toggle the visibility of associated content. You can use classes and CSS, or you can use conditional logic. It really depends on your situation. Okay, I guess that's all for now. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, please check out my channel for more videos on various other topics and features within Angular. Until next time, thanks for watching.